G'day gang, and it's another dose of out of the frying pan into another frying pan, I think, for this guy. Oh, hang on, I'll be back. Well, g'day gang, I'll try it for the second time. This is a case of out of the frying pan into another frying pan. This vehicle that I have it here at the moment belonged to the gentleman with the Holden Rodeo that with the Alloy Tech engine that the valve dropped. Remember that one? Smashed up all number one cylinder. Well, he thought he'd do himself a favour, and he went out and he bought himself a Ranger 2.2 diesel. He's had it for about a month now, I believe. And yes, he's had it for about a month. Anyway, so he brought it up the driveway the other day, and I thought to myself, that doesn't sound quite right. And he said there was engine code, the check light was on the dashboard. And so I said, oh, that sounds like it's got a problem with the charge pipe or something off the turbocharger. I could hear what sounded like boost escaping somewhere. God, key's not on. Silly me. We'll try again. Here we go. Don't know why it's got glow plug circuits. Knacked. Mass airflow meter. Airflow too high. Okay, so I'm going to get rid of that, because I need to get rid of that, and I'll show you what I found. Okay. I'll show you what I found. Now, keep in mind, this has got 170,000 kilometres on it. And I have the grill out of it. First place I looked was the intercooler. I saw the oil everywhere. I said, that's got to be that. And here's the interesting thing. I'll turn the camera upside down so you can see this. Now, where are we? There we are. Did you read that date? Yeah, and this is a 2012, so this has already been replaced once. Now, I don't know whether or not it's gotten full of oil, which is quite common. There's a company now that's come out with catch cans for these things to catch the oil, because it does get very oily in the inlet tubes. But anyway, so $400 or something for a new intercooler from Ford. Guy needs the car. Well, let's get it done. So that's the intercooler out. No, I'll just tip him up over here and see how much oil comes out. I thought that would have pulled out of there. Well, I'll just leave him sitting up like that, because there's going to be oil coming out of that, you guarantee. Aftermarket box. Genuine cooler. All I have to do is just poke him back in the hole. Piece of cake. Yep, it's very simple. Two studs sticking out here. Two bolts go in the bottom. You can see there. like that. Hook your hoses up. They come through in the right place right there. Can you see? There. And job should be done. And there we go. And if I said it took 10 minutes, I don't think I'd be exaggerating at all. That's all it took. Maximum 10. I'll go for a gallop in it. Should be good as gold. Check you later. And so we're back from the test drive. Whack the scanner in again. We'll just see what it's got to say. And see if it still has any codes in there, hopefully. It said, hopefully it says there's no problems. I'm thinking that maybe the glow plugs have cancelled out or something like that, because there's no boost. Therefore it's going to want to, I expect. Run somewhat richer. Right, we've still got glow plug issues. Okay. But the other bit's gone. It starts up fine. So maybe that's a job for another day. Well, the guy needs to take his vehicle. But anyways, our problem is gone. Check you later.